Hello, my name is David Meany, VP of Technical Sales and Marketing at ECS Inc. International. In this multi-part series, we will look at oscillator design basics. We will cover all the steps required to design and build a functioning oscillator. In this first episode, we will discuss oscillators and oscillator principles. But first, let us review. What is an oscillator? An oscillator is an electronic circuit which generates a repetitive signal. This signal can be in many forms depending on the application. Some applications require a basic clock to maintain operational intervals for processors. Other applications require a clock with very clean waveform and tight stability to produce high-quality communications data transfers. In analog applications such as RF radio transceivers that use a superheterodyne to receive and transmit signal chains, we typically find a sinusoidal output waveform. A sine wave is a continuous wave that represents a smooth periodic oscillation. In RF communications, the oscillator sine wave output provides an accurate, low noise frequency reference to the transceiver. In digital electronics, we see square wave outputs. Square waves are a waveform that alternates from minimum to maximum amplitude at a steady frequency. An ideal square wave would have the minimum and maximum periods at equal duration. This would be a 50-50 duty cycle. In practice, there will be some variation in duty cycles, so a 45-55 or 60-40 may be more typical. A square wave output signal has many uses, but it's extensively used to time the execution and instructions in a circuit or microprocessor. Now let us look at different types of resonators. Oscillators can have different types of resonators associated with them. The most prolific and best performing of these is quartz. You may also find oscillators that use ceramic, SAW, or MEMS-based resonators to be the starting point for the operational frequency. They use mechanical vibration or tuned cavities to generate the clock signal. In the case of quartz-based oscillator, the composition of the quartz material and the angles that the crystals are cut make this type of oscillator very precise and stable over a wide temperature range. The process for making oscillator-grade crystal blanks is time-consuming with many steps to ensure consistent high-quality product, but they offer vastly superior stability over RC oscillators. Let's continue with oscillator principles. The principle behind the oscillator circuit is a stable, steady-state output signal. One way to accomplish this is by using a positive feedback loop. Here, a portion of the output voltage is fed back to the input with no net phase shift. This feedback reinforces the output signal. The signal is then amplified and looped back again, causing the output signal to grow. The gain in the feedback loop needs to be controlled to unity gain. Otherwise, the signal will be clipped and distorted. In the illustration shown, we see a simplified oscillator circuit that consists of an amplification stage, a feedback network, and a filter that decides what the feedback loop gain should be. In this next illustration, we see a Pierce oscillator circuit, commonly used in digital processor designs. In this type of oscillator design, the filter consists of the crystal's equivalent model and the external load capacitors. The exact frequency at which an oscillator will operate is dependent on the loop phase angle shifts within the oscillator circuit. Changes in the phase angle will result in a change in the output frequency. To learn more about oscillator design basics, stay tuned for the oscillator startup time and reactance in an oscillator circuit, or visit us online at ecsxtal.com.